Here's an overview of the wetland restoration project going on here in Shoshone. This is habitat for both the pupfish and the vole. They're trying to reintroduce the vole. We're here at the Shoshone Pupfish Wetlands Project area.
Welcome, Tom and Julie.
We're here with Clay and Hello. Julie. Okay, we're going to do a quick little tour of the pupfish ponds and just give you a little explanation of what's going on with them.
Well, these are the people involved in it along on the bottom there, along right. with the landowner, Susan Sorrells. And she's really done a lot here. And we'll take a little walk.
So they were considered extinct at one point?
Yes, about 15, 20 years ago. And then a biologist named Betsy and Susan discovered some in a little slough in here.
Okay.
And they were kept alive, basically, and now they've propagated, and there is thousands and thousands of them.
And so does this pool have a name?
School ponds.
This is school pond?
There's two of them right here.
So these are school ponds.
We used to send the water down through this box here. It went down to a large birding pond.
Okay.
Across the road there. Took it off and down into that new pond right down there by the highway.
Okay, so this is a school pond, and this is a school pond, and
yes,
here
sir.
Here now I'm starting to see some pupfish in there.
Oh, you'll see lots of pupfish.
Okay, so this is a school pond, and you do some maintenance on this too, right?
Every 2 weeks we have to trim all the ponds, but you and Julie should know because you helped.
We did help. You have to trim the reeds out.
All right, let's stop right on the bridge here.
Okay.
This is the pupfish flow coming down here, and we just diverted water over to this new project over here. This is for the Amargosa Vole. UC Davis is taking care of this part of it. So they're going to reintroduce the Amargosa Vole here, which numbers are extremely low, and there is none in Shoshone right now.
I see you planted some reeds over here or something.
Great old broads did that.
Okay.
About 2 weeks ago. We just got to keep it watered.
Okay, but that's not going to be a pond.
No.
All right, let's go look at another pond.
This pond here, the next one, is named after Susan, the landowner.
Okay.
Susan's pond. It took, the Great Basin Conservancy Corps out of Las Vegas, they cut this little stretch up here out.
The little ditch?
Yeah, it took them about 4 days to do it. It took 2 weeks to get from this pond, Susan's pond, to the school pond to cut all the brush that was in here.
Oh boy, yeah, it's pretty thick.
There was only two fish we could find in here when we did this.
It's pretty thick, and what are these things?
Oh, those are mesquites.
That's mesquite, and
they love to bite.
Yeah, it's got a big barb on it, and it's pretty thick in there, isn't it? Okay, so this is Susan's pond.
Yes, sir.
All right, let's go find another one.
Yeah, we'll go right on up the slough here.
Okay.
We just put a little dam in down there to slow the water.
Oh, yeah,
I see it right there.
Yeah, I see it.
And that, the flow there was real rocky, and they need mud to breed in.
They like to hide in there too, don't they?
Yeah. Yeah, as you know, when you started working on these ponds, they go right down in the mud.
Yeah, they hide in there.
They can live in the mud.
They like it in there. So here's your ditch. Look at the reeds are already growing back.
Yeah, when did we do this?
About a week ago at the most.
This thing is loaded with pupfish. Do you see them all in there? Now if there's mud in there, they're really having a heyday.
They're having a field day in there, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, let's continue. Up the ditch we go.
This is a pretty special habitat for being in the middle of the desert.
Exactly. This is an old spring, right? And this is a warm spring.
Yes, it's 90 degrees. Comes out of the ground at 90.
Right, 90 degrees. That's looking back at the little ditch.
This is this is a junction for two different ponds that are piped into this location.
Okay, now what pond is this one?
This is named after Betsy.
This is Betsy, the one who rediscovered them?
Yes, her and Susan.
Okay. And let's see what we have in here. Oh, I see pupfish going all over the place.
Yeah, this was totally overgrown when we started this in 11.
Okay. And you would have no idea how many pupfish would be in any of these ponds, right?
Steve, the California Fish and Game biologist in charge of it now, says if you see one, you see 20.
I see. Okay.
He's a whisperer of pupfish.
Is he pupfish whisperer?
Yeah, Steve Parmenter out of Bishop.
Okay. We going this way?
Yes, sir.
Let's follow Julie.
Next pond we're coming to is the 49er pond.
Okay.
We call it that because we put 49 fish in it.
All right.
And they're a happy fish.
Now, can they get from pond to pond or can't they?
They can't come upstream, but they can go down, and they do. Because we never put any fish down below Betsy's pond.
Okay, so they've all migrated down.
Yep.
Now, are they at their peak blue, or are they losing some of their blue? Because I think they were more blue a couple weeks ago.
I think we'll get to the next pond where there'll be a lots of blue ones.
Okay. And blue is a male?
That's the large males. They don't like to propagate no more. They like to fight.
Okay.
They get a little territorial. This is all this spike grass. Steve planted all this in here.
So that's a good thing.
Yeah, that's really good stuff. Susan's grandfather planted that.
He did.
Look at all the twists in it.
Yeah, it's crazy, isn't it?
This is some more habitat that they're working on for the Amargosa vole.
Right. So are there no voles here now?
None.
They're going to reintroduce
it. Yeah, they took a couple, three. I think they studied about 3 years looking for them. They couldn't find any.
Okay.
But they are in Tecopa.
Who is Susan's grandfather? Not Charles Brown.
Yeah.
Was it? Okay. All right, here we go. This is what pond?
This is... Well, it's called the Fairy Pond, but actually it's Steve's Fairy Pond.
So this is the biggest pond, it looks like.
Yes, and this is the newest pond.
Oh, it is?
Besides the one at the bottom we'll walk to last.
Okay.
This is the newest one, a couple years old. We put, 120 fish in here. As you can see, this pond is loaded.
Now, where did you, when you put fish in, where are they coming from?
We brought them in here.
From?
Down.
Just from another pond?
Yeah. Betsy's pond is where it all starts.
Okay.
And when Steve comes back here, he mixes the fish so their gene pool progresses.
Okay, let's walk around this pond and then we'll...
Here, take a look at this right here, this entrance.
Okay.
That's where the water comes. There's a little spring up here.
Mm-hmm.
This is the only spring, actual water that comes out of the ground that's feeding this side of the habitat.
Okay. And the spring is back up in there.
Yes.
Which is so thick you can't even get through there.
Yep.
All right, so here we go.
This is also home to the Shoshone spring snail, the only place in the world.
Really?
Yep.
Never heard of it.
We just planted these.
Yeah, these are little willows, it looks like.
Yeah, coyote willows.
And they're doing pretty well.
Yeah, they look happy for 4 weeks.
Right. So here's some more pupfish.
Don't these look awful big?
Yeah, that's got a bad angle with the sun, but let me go back over here, we'll find some more. So now this is coming in from a different spot.
This is actually coming in from the pipe that feeds the pool.
Okay, yeah, and you have a nice pool here too, a nice warm water pool.
90 degrees mineral water.
90 degrees all the time. Okay, pupfish, where are you? There's some out here. There they are. They're chunky little guys, aren't they? Just up the hill from this highest pupfish pond are the remnants of an old house where a Native American man named George Ross was born. They're not sure exactly, but around 90 to 95 years ago. And he just passed away this last week. He was one of the old time Shoshoneans. So I thought I'd get a little picture of this just as a little tribute to George. Hi there. So Clay, you've done a lot of work on the path around here too.
We try. Robbie, my wife, and I'll tell you that Great Basin Conservancy Corps, those kids, they bring kids in here, five or six of them, they are hard workers. So.
And you got a nice boardwalk.
Hey, we put this boardwalk in to cover the pool pipe.
Oh, I see. Yeah, the pipe.
6-inch pipe feeding into the, this is the back of the pool.
This is the back of the pool, right. And it's a fun pool. It's nice water.
Check a look out that bench. It's caveman style.
Yep. That's a big chunk of salt cedar, I bet.
Yeah, it's all cedar here. We can do so much with it because it grows so fast.
And there are
it's
a lot of
highly invasive.
Yeah, there are a lot of them.
This is the other side of the vole habitat.
Right.
A guy named Leonard. Leonard's a bird man of Shoshone. You can look him up on the internet. Stop right here. He crawled, look at this little pond in here. That's a spring source. He crawled through all of this and identified where the water was coming from. Yeah, he likes to get down there and he crawls right through the mesquite.
I know how you can get, you can't even see through there, much less walk through there.
Yeah. Yeah, Leonard the bird man of Shoshone.
Cool.
Hello.
Hey.
So that's pretty much the loop. When we come up to the last pond, we call it the dog pond.
Okay.
Old Wilfred H. Dog likes to get wet in it.
Wilfred Hound Dog.
Well, how'd you know his middle name?
Because you told me.
As you can see, it's a new pond. Look at the...
There's a coot in there.
The newer the pond, the algae will build up.
Okay. And you got to rake that out. We raked some out the other day.
Yeah, we rake it out. You guys did up there.
I don't see too many fish in here.
It's hard to see them because of the algae.
Right.
They're in there.
Oh, I see some little ones, yeah.
Yep, there are a couple darted.
Okay, well, that's a pretty good little tour. Let's thank Clay and Julie for taking us around the thing. Thank you, guys.
You're welcome.
You're welcome, Tom.